Okay, so this is my Ender 3 Pro. I got it about 5 months ago. It's a fully open source printer, super cheap, super high quality, and it prints super well. So there's lots of upgrades and stuff and things for us to do. So as soon as I got it, I just had to start upgrading. This is the first upgrade I actually did to it. It was supposed to make it quieter, and it was a 3D printed fan duct, but it never printed well, it didn't make a difference. So this is the old motor spacer, and then this is the new one. All they do is make a difference in space between the Z-axis motor to stop the Z-axis rod from bending. So this is a simple 3D printed filament guide. Basically the filament just clips under the guide and feeds into the extruder, which makes it super simple. These are just simple 3D printed cable chains. There's one set for the X-axis and then one set for the Y-axis. They basically just tuck it in a bit more and make it a bit more neat. And they're really simple, they just click together. It took about 10 hours for printing for all of them. And yeah. So this is just a simple scraper holder. It's a scraper that comes with the Ender 3, and it's just somewhere to put it. It just slots down one of the sides and you can just put your scraper in it. So this is just a simple LCD screen circuit board cover which just protects it. It uses 4 bolts, but it's exactly the same price and it has the one connector that you need to connect the LCD screen connector to. This is just another very simple upgrade. It's just an LCD screen cover so you can stop dust getting on it, and when you're asleep and if it's in your room you don't have the really bright LCD screen light. Here's another very simple upgrade. It's just a red knob that replaces the old LCD screen turning knob, and it kind of matches the colour of it. It looks a bit nicer, so that's why I printed it. So this is basically just a 3D printed cable cover for the Y axis. It doesn't really do much, but it looks nice, so that's why I printed it. So this is probably the most useful upgrade of them all. Basically this directs all of the air from that fan directly to the hot end. This is the old cooling duct, so it only directed air all the way around it, and then this is the new one. It has a point where it directs it exactly to it and gets as much cooling air as it can on it, so then it cools the hot end. This is basically just a storage box that fits between the motherboard and the LCD screen. It slides right through the metal parts and fits exactly in. these are just little 3D printer cable clips. They just clip on to the back of the 3D printer where the box goes, and they basically just help hold in the LCD screen cable and make it a bit neater and stop it from getting bent or broken. Well, this is a 3D printed extruder knob. It makes life a lot easier when feeding out the filament out of the nozzle, so it comes out super easy. It takes about an hour to 3D print and works really well. This upgrade is about 1000 IQ. This just uses the packaging that comes with the 3D printer and puts it on the bottom of the legs, which makes shock absorbing and noise a lot quieter. The only downside of this is that they can start to wear out over time, so you should replace them. There are also these 3D printer ones, but I didn't bother to do them because of our packaging. Okay, so that was the first 13 upgrades you could do that were completely free. The next three are ones that you have to buy. This upgrade you have to buy, but they're quite cheap. They're only about £3 from Banggood. They're springs from Coyote and they're a lot more rigid. They basically make it so when you're levelling your bed and you accidentally nudge it, you're not going to have to re-level it again. This is an upgrade I highly recommend you getting. Okay, so this was the original bed that came with the printer. It came with a magnetic base. So in order to install the glass bed, you have to peel it off. I heated my bed up to about 60 degrees and then used the scraper to peel it off. It was reasonably easy, but just don't burn your hands. This glass bed comes with two sides, one side that's kind of gritty and gets lots of adhesion, and then the other side which is just plain glass, which comes out with really nice smooth prints. I like to use the shiny smooth glass side because it basically leaves a really nice shiny smooth print, and whereas the other side is kind of a bit dotty and it leaves some dotty marks. But here's what it looks like with just the glass side. Super smooth, super shiny. So this is the SQR Mini E3 by Big Tree Tech, and this directly replaces the old Ender 3 board, which is the one I'm holding right now, and all the slots go in the same place. I bought this because it makes the printer motors pretty much silent and all you can hear are the fans, which is a really good benefit when you're trying to get to sleep. So I guess that's it, all 16 upgrades done for the Ender 3 Pro. I'd recommend all of them, they're all really good upgrades, most of them are free, the ones to buy are totally recommended. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching the video. All the links will be in the description for all the parts of the new printer and everything bought. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you next time.